So we have spent a little bit of time here in the modeler, but we haven't spent too much time in the properties panel, which is where we're going to spend some time now, because that's where all the technical details are added. So if I open up this little thing here, we have Lafayette process. Here is the name of the process that we're building. I'm actually going to just copy this and give it a name. This is the human readable name. It's executable, which is great. And so these are the overall properties of the model. Now we actually want specifically to change the properties of this task and this task. So I'm going to select this and I'm going to go to forms, and here we have form key. Now there's lots of ways of adding forms to a user task. We're using Camunda forms, which means that we're going to have to tell the engine how to generate the form. And we just need to fill this with a specific string. The string basically needs to reference this file here, the prepare for departure file. So what I have here is, and let me talk through what this string says. It says Camunda forms. That is the first thing that we know. We need to tell the engine that this is going to be using Camunda forms rather than, let's say, an embedded form or an external form. We're going to use external forms. Now we need to know where it's located. In Spring Boot, they're going to look into static in that folder that we created earlier, and specifically the forms folder where we actually put our forms. And next, we just need to place the name of the form. Ours is called Prepare for Departure. So that is the name of the form which we will be using. So that should do the trick. For the other one, the Get Taxi, I'm going to copy that. I'm going to select Get Taxi. I'm going to place Get Taxi form, and that should then load that form. So let's save that model, and now everything should be ready to get started for the first time. So let's start the process up. Starting the Spring Boot application is actually very, very simple. I'm going to make sure everything's saved and then head back to my IntelliJ and find the application. You have a file, right click, click run. So what this will do is it will build my project, and it will then get all the necessary dependencies and then just start it up. It's very, very easy. And you can see here that it's going to begin with a lovely Camunda BPM, or Camunda platform written there. And then it's going to start up. Now, what we're actually going to do is we're going to access the engine by using the front end applications. This is task list and cockpit. So these were added initially through the POM file right here with this dependency. These web apps allow you to be able to start processes, complete tasks, and also view the current process and see where the tokens are and that sort of thing. So we're going to be doing that next. Now, how to access that is pretty easy. We see here that this is already started. If you see starting to acquire jobs, that is a good sign. It means things have started. So now we can open up a web browser, go to a new tab, and click localhost 8080. And then we are greeted by a login page. Now, in this login page, you may be wondering, well, how do I log in? Well, luckily, you should remember that demo is the default. But if you don't know the default, then have no fear, because you can always check the application YAML file. I'm going to enable statistics because I'm interested in statistics, and close this. Okay, here we are. So this is the welcome page where we have the two main front-end applications I talked to you about, cockpit and task list. I'm going to open up cockpit in a different tab and then go to task list to start my process. Okay, so here we are in task list. So task list works by having some filters to filter the tasks that exist. So I'm going to click add simple filter. This will show us all tasks that are available. And here is a list of tasks that are currently available. There's none. So I'm going to go up to the top right, and then I want to click on start process. There should only be one process called Lafayette, which there is. And if I click on that, I'm asked to enter a business key, which we don't need in this case. I'm just going to click start. So what this will do is it will start the process. You can see in the bottom right that it says process has been started. If I click on the all tasks one more time, it will refresh and I'll see prepare for departure. And in fact, if I click on that, you'll see that I'm able to see the task that we created, or the front end we created for the task. Meanwhile, in cockpit, if we go and to the other tab we opened, if you don't have it already open, you can look in the top right little house. You can select cockpit right there. Here we have the what's going on in the engine. There's not too much. If I click on processes, I can see that my Lafayette process is here and the number of running instances is one. So if I go inside this process, I should be able to see what's happening. And right now, as you can see, we are here and prepare for departure. Great. So this is an admin view to see what's going on. Meanwhile, our task view shows more of a perspective of an end user of the process. So let's complete this task. So I'm going to click on claim in the top right because this right now is read only because unless somebody claims the task, they can't access the data. So I'm going to claim that. And I'm going to add some cash. So how much cash we bring? Maybe 12,000. As we know, we need to add a decimal. So there we go. That's bad enough, I think. Currency is not relevant. Where are we headed? So as you may remember, I have a regex ensuring that I can only really go to two places. So France. It also ensures my spelling is correct, which I quite like. I could also go to America. Okay, and as you can see, it references the pattern that we need to go. I'm going to be happy with France. I'm living in Berlin, so France is much closer and easier to get to via taxi. So I'm going to click complete. Great. And now our next task shows up. Get a taxi. There we go. And you can see it has the data from the previous task already there. We also have, if we go to cockpit and refresh this view, we should see the process has moved on to the next task, which of course it has. And now I can claim this task and I can enter my money for the taxi, let's say 10 quid. It's a very, very cheap taxi. And I'm going to click complete one more time. And we arrive at overthrow the monarchy. Now you may remember that I did not add a form for this task. That was entirely done on purpose. It's because I want to show you what we can do with a default sort of empty task. This is really handy for sort of testing and prototyping. If I claim this task now, I'm able to load all of the variables in the current context. So if I click load, you'll see that I have the country, I have the my money and taxi costs, and I can also add variables if I need to. So that's a really handy way of being able to just verify what's happened and get access to them in development or in design time. And once I complete this, the process should end. But of course, Lafayette deserves more than this, mainly because Lafayette maybe might want to travel in more than just taxi. It's not very useful, especially not for long distances in like America. So the next thing we're going to do is we're actually going to add some new content to our process model to allow us to use the data added by the user, specifically their destination, to decide on the method of travel. And for that, we're going to return to our process model.